Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, with another in the series. Well, if you've been watching the series, you know I built a new recorder, and the cylinder recordings I've been making tonight are actually pretty good. Some of them are surprisingly good. But I designed it for recording with the recordette and doing on direct electric transfers from the archive of streaming audio. Well, I wanted to see how it will sound as an acoustic recorder. I haven't tested that yet. So I've got the gym, and I uploaded a couple of videos tonight of the gym playing. I've got it tuned, and it's running really well, as you can probably hear. So it's running really stable. It's actually sounding quite good. So what I'm going to do is a quick voice recording with a speaking tube using the new recorder. Recording on a black wax recording blank. And as I mentioned, the new recorder that I built, extended use recorder, allows you to record down to the point where, in fact, I've got an example here. That white spot is the cord showing through the wax. So I've shaved it down to the point where I'm actually starting to hit the cord, and I can still record on the cylinder, and it is virtually paper thin. But as I said, I've designed this recorder for doing recordings with the recordette and streaming audio, but I want to see how it's going to sound as an acoustic recorder. So I figured the best way to test it would be on the gym. And now that the gym's running well, I bought the gym. This is another one of those eBay machines that couldn't be fixed. As I keep saying, don't overlook the junk. I paid, I think, $235 for this with the lid. Of course, it didn't run, but it was nothing but adjustments. There was nothing wrong with it. There was nothing physically wrong with it. It's just that all the adjustments were really, really... Some have been in there mucking around with the bearings, and the bearings were so tight the machine couldn't run no matter what you did. And the secret of the gym, of course, is to build in lots of slop to get to know your gym and then tune it. And if you take in consideration all the bearings there are in this machine, and if they're even the slightest bit too tight, you add them all together and the machine becomes really erratic or really slow or almost powerless. This machine, fully wound, will play almost two full cylinders. And so you have more than enough power to record end-to-end on a recording blank. And that's what I bought the gym for, was to use it as a small portable recorder. They're great little machines. And considering how small they are, it's still a working Edison phonograph that not only plays, but also records. So we're going to test this new recorder as a straight acoustic recorder. And I'm going to do a quick recording with the speaking tube. This is the dictation link speaking tube. So I've got the machine fully wound, the new recorder's installed, the speaking tube, and for recording music, forget it. The gym just isn't stable enough to do music recordings. For doing voice recordings, it's great. It makes really great voice recordings. Now we're just going to see how well this recorder works as an acoustic recorder. So, start the machine. As soon as we drop the stylus, the recording will begin. Greetings and salutations, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy doing a quick recording on the Edison Gem phonograph. This is the new recorder that I built for doing streaming audio recordings with the recordette, but I have not tried it yet as an acoustic recorder. So I thought I'd just throw it on the Gem, use the dictation link speaking tube, and do a straight acoustic recording to see what kind of recording it would make. As I said, I designed this for transferring streaming audio directly to the cylinder, so I'm not quite sure how it's going to work as an acoustic recorder. So recording this with the dictation link speaking tube on the Edison Gem, recording on a shaved and trimmed black wax Edifone cylinder, and this is going to be an interesting test to see what kind of acoustic recording we get. So this is Benjamin the Victrola Guy making a quick recording with the speaking tube on the Edison Gem phonograph. Alright, stop the machine. And as always, like I always say, take the recorder off the machine and put it back in its box. These things are worth their weight in gold, and if you drop one, it will never be the same again. So, we remove the cylinder. Plenty of swarf. Grab my swarf brush. And once you get to know your machine and you've done some recording, you can look at the grooves and tell approximately what kind of recording you've got. This is a fair recording, no doubt. And as I said, I've never done an acoustic recording with this recorder. So it's actually going to be interesting to see how it works. So install our Model C reproducer. Reinstall the cylinder. And I'm going to use one of the fiberboard horns. Now the nice thing about these fiberboard horns is they're the same length as a witch's hat. They sound as good as a witch's hat, and they weigh nothing. 2.2 ounces. So let me get out of the shot. I'm not going to rewind the machine. It should have more than enough power to play that. Let's see how we did with this new recorder. I think you will agree that was a fairly good recording, considering it was recorded with a speaking tube on an Edison Gem. These are really underrated machines. When you get them running, they're actually very good little phonographs. The trouble is getting them running well. And it takes a bit of adjustment, and really that's all it is. If the spring in it is of original strength, there's really nothing wrong. Yes, they're underpowered. They really are. But when the machine's tuned, you have more than enough power to play one cylinder. In fact, you have enough power to record one full cylinder. And so what if you have to wind it every time you play it? And it's not that bad of a trade-off, considering how small this machine is. And now being able to make some really decent voice recordings on some very, very small wax cylinders. With a speaking tube, and the nice thing about the speaking tube, of course, is you don't have to carry a horn. If you have your speaking tube, you can listen back either through the tube itself or take the bell off and put it directly on the gem. And let me play a bit of this recording so you can hear it through this little horn. And it's not going to win any prizes for fidelity, but it does play the cylinder. Self-contained little package. You can take a few blank cylinders, the speaking tube, or a recording horn, and take the gem, and you can go do public demonstrations, and better, you can do remote recordings. You can actually take this little machine out with you, and as far as voice recording goes, it works great. You can play it back on any other Edison cylinder phonograph, and it's running at the correct speed. It will record for about 2 minutes and 25 seconds on the cylinder. And there's enough power in the machine to actually record end to end. So a successful experiment. The new recorder works not only well for the recordette, but it makes more than acceptable voice recordings using a speaking tube. So if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. answer all of my email, try to answer the day I get it. But if you have any questions or comments about anything I covered in my YouTube series, the recorder, recording on the Edison cylinder phonograph, if you need blank wax cylinders, I have almost 1,000 blanks in stock. I've got recording horns, speaking tubes, listening tubes, floor cranes, virtually anything as far as an original accessory for the Edison cylinder phonograph I've replicated. So if you do have any questions or comments about anything covered in my YouTube series, feel free to drop me an email. If you have a problem with one of your machines, I always do whatever I can to help. So as always, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.